Hi, Carol here, and welcome to my September YouTube My Besties Design Team project. I think you're really going to love it. We're going to be using Gamsol and Prisma pencils, of course, and I'm going to show you a wonderful technique that I use with these delicious, yummy Prisma pencils. I absolutely love using Prisma pencils. And we're going to use this My Besties image by Sherry Baldy, and I'll put all the information in the description box. I don't use that blue sheet, but I do use the pink, blue, and greens in this image. So I'm going to use that piece of 12 by 12 paper. And of course, I'm going to be using cupcake and cookie boxes. I'm going to use the pink one, and I'm going to mix it up with a mixed media style box. I use gold tissue, I don't use that blue, and because there's gold in that paper, and I think you're really going to enjoy this. I call this my tri-coloring technique. It is 3-in-1, and I really enjoy doing this with Prisma pencils because it allows you to not only take your dark to your light and all the way through the mid-tone there, you can back it up or forward it. And I'll show you what I mean when I do this. I lay out three colors, my dark tone, my mid-tone, and my light tone, just around the edges first. Then I take my stump, and I'll use all different size stumps, from real narrow ones to nice chunky ones. And you can see that I lay out three colors at once, all the way through this image. It's three colors, even if they're different colors. Because you'll see, well, it's four colors there, right? Because I'm doing the cheeks, but you can see I haven't applied Gamsol yet till right now. And then I'm going to move these colors as I want them moved. If I want the light to come up to the dark, I move my Gamsol to the dark. If I want my dark to move down, I move it with the Gamsol. And I find this really works for skin tones especially. And then I move in with a fourth color. And I'll list the colors for you I'm going to show you the colors. I'm going to slow the process down to show you which ones I use all the time for skin tones. And I love this technique because you can make it seamless, believe it or not. Even though you can see that I'm putting the dark tone on last, I always put the dark tone around the face image last. And then I'll move it with the Gamsol, and then I'll go back on the cheeks. And if I have to apply any other color, see how I'm doing the three colors on the neck, on the shoulders, and then I'm going to move in with the Gamsol with a thinner stump, and look at that beautiful blend. It's absolutely stunning. One thing I want to mention that I'm showing you here with the pencils is I make sure I always have a perfect point. I have my electronic sharpener beside me, and I sharpen them continually. I find that when I go around in little circles, that it really helps to have it in a point. And here's the numbers here, a 1010 and a 929 and a 1099 and a 1033 and a 945, and then the bottom one is a deep brown. I'm not showing it on there, but it's the dark, really dark brown. Yeah, Carol, you should have moved that up. And here's the dark brown. So I have my light source coming in from the center. You'll always see me doing a light pencil wherever I want the sunlight to show up. And here I am moving the color with the stump. I've put three colors on at one time. It's like those tritone colors pencils that you can buy. I have them, and they have three colors wound in one. Well, after using them, I figured out that it works really well to do it with your own Prisma pencils, like one at a time, and see how I'm applying three colors. And then I add the pink tone for the knees, and then I move in with my Gamsol, and then I take my colors with the Gamsol and move them where I want them to be situated. And I find this works really well. And then I back up with a light tone if I want to move anything. I want to show you this. There's my sharpener. I'm always doing this. and to make sure they're always pointy. You can see how much I have in the well. So let's move on and I'll show you it in fast motion. Thought I'd show you here, I always use this mauve underneath for black hair. I use a navy, as you can see me there. I slowed this down to show you the hair process with my Prisma pencils. I always saturate it with one color, and that would be the mauve. And then I move into the bottom layer and the top layer. I leave the center open, and I go in now with navy. And I'm going over the lines because when I apply my black, this hinted line of navy will show through, especially when you're doing this image, because this is like you've got a wave going on each piece of hair. So you want to apply whatever colors you want to show through as an undertone. And I do this all the time, when even with my Copics. I always apply an undertone color, a lighter color, and then I'll use a dark color, and you can see how I situate the lines because I use the black on the outside. And I know it's when you're going a little fast here, it is a little difficult to see, and I never take my hand and, well, I can't say never, but I try not to move the pencil with my hand, like pushing all the little pieces off. I take the paper up and I just give it a shake. So here I'm taking that really pointy. I can't stress enough how I make sure my pencils have a real point on them. I like to work that way. Not everybody likes to work with a pointed pencil, but I do. And I will remove color. First I'll blend it in with the stump. And then if I want to remove any color, like any dark color, I will do it with a lighter pencil. And you'll see me do that. So here I'm coming in with the black. And then you'll see I want to remove some of it so that there's a hint of shadow. But when you're doing a child face, child hair, it's not the face, it's the hair. You want to always remember they don't have a lot of highlights because they're younger. They're going to have sunlight opposed to highlight. So I'll show you how I do that. I'm taking that real pointed black pencil and I'm going over the eyelashes, the eyebrows, and I'm making it really distinct. I love these eyelashes that Sherry puts on her images. They're absolutely stunning. And then I'll back up and I'll go over just the marks. You can see I don't do a lot of filling in right now with the black. I'm going to move it with the stump, and that makes it more realistic. It moves the navy and the mauve out to the edges. Now here I'm coming in with light gray, and I'm going to add the sunlight marks. And I find I really like the way this works for me. And I'm always moving in the direction of the hair. This is going to have like little wee buns. That's how I look at it, like little wee cinnamon buns all the way down there. It's a beautiful, beautiful image. And then I take the stump and I blend it in. And as you can see, I'm using a yellow. I mean, who would think you'd use a yellow? But it's sunlight, right? It's sunlight coming down onto the hair. So I do cast some yellow, light yellow in the image. And now I go back with the black, going in the exact motion that I feel the hairs are going. And I use to remove my pencil. If I want to remove any pencil, I do it with a light gray because I'm using black. So I swing right over to the lightest color, a light gray. And you can see under there, you're picking up the navy, you're picking up the yellow, and you're also picking up the mauve, which makes it look like it has that strip of sunlight going down the middle. It's a wonderful, wonderful technique to use to make sure you always remember to remove with a lighter pencil and then add again. And right at the end, I will add the black. I'll leave it here like this to rest, and then I'll go back in to take away any of the sunlight I want to have hair marks on. And I find this works really well for me. I'm not afraid to experiment with color, all different colors. I'll do undertones, and then I'll bring those undertones up with a darker color. And when I do my lips, I make sure that the center of the lip is lighter than the outside of the lip. There's the light color coming in, and then I'll come in with a deeper red later. I'm going to move it with the Gamsol, but then I'm going to come in with that really nice deep fuchsia. It's kind of like a fuchsia. Now with the eyes, I move the blue only on the, I leave the bottoms clear. I make them with a light gray, the bottom. And then I use the blue Prisma pencil and I'll move it with the Gamsol. And then with my black pencil, as fine as I can get it on the sharpener, I make the little lines on the top. And I also make those little lines that you have in your eyes on the bottom. And it just pops them. It's just a wonderful technique to use. See the lines in there? Like that. It looks so distinct and pretty. And I'm doing it on the other eye. And then I'm going to use my enamel accents to do the black eyeball and the white highlight in the eyes later on down the video. And then I use a skin tone to go over the eye right here. I don't keep anything white. I'll keep it in the flesh tones. And then I'm going to move on to show you how I, in fast motion, do the clothing. And always watch how I keep the sunlight in the center. I love the part of making the pleats in the dress and continuing that on with the little ruffles. And now I'm going to use my white enamel accents to highlight those little dots on the handkerchief that's in her hair. And I just think this image is absolutely adorable. I really enjoyed doing the coloring on this with Prisma pencils. And don't be afraid to experiment with all kinds of colors, because you can always lift them and you can always remove them with a lighter color. So you're very seldom going to find yourself in a bad way with Prisma pencils with any colors you want to mix up. you notice that I did put a lot of colors on top, layering and layering and layering, removing it and adding it, removing it and adding it. And here I'm going to add some glossy accents to her little bib and down on the bow, her lips, and that pretty well takes care of that. And now I'll move in with the hair with the finest point on the black as I can. I just go over and check how much of that highlight, and I want to make sure that the hair marks of each individual hair pops out on this image. So I go over it at the end. When I'm satisfied, we're going to move on to the gift box. Love this. I'm going to use the fuse tool and the fusible ribbon. And all this does, you don't need to have plastic here, this fusible ribbon that you buy, it makes it look like a stitching, and it fuses it together on this paper. It is made to fuse together, and you'll get this pleated look with the fuse ruler. They now have this large ruler, which is really nice. And look at that. You have an instant pleat for any project that you have. So I fussy cut around the entire My Bestie image. Oh yes. And then I'm going to take a black 100 Copic marker and go around all the edges. I want to take this ordinary gift box and see how it folds in. Well, I remedy that by putting some cotton lace on there, pulling it so that it won't cave in on me as much. And I do it on each side. And then I take a doily that I have, and I cut two little round doilies out that I'm going to put in the center to hold those little pleats so that it doesn't cave in, because I'm going to put tissue paper and some gifts inside there for a birthday. So I thought that would look really cute. And to stabilize the sides of this, I had some extra thick ribbon that was almost the size of the sides. So I decided to run down the hot glue on just the thicker parts of this beautiful ribbon. It's a nice, thick, firm ribbon. I really like it. And then I'm going to take a frill, just a polyester lace frill, and go around that, as you can see right here on the top, just to kind of give it that shabby chic vintage look. And this is just out of inexpensive boxes that you get for cupcakes, and I'm going to use it to put birthday gifts inside. And then I cut that off. I leave the back clear, and then I use this beautiful gold tissue paper here, and that's where I'm going to put my gifts inside there. You can see how I have the paper facing me up there, the 12 by 12, because this way I want to use up all the colors that are in there. There's gold, there's blue, there's green, there's pink, and I try to put a little bit of that all the way through the box there. And the gold matches the gold in the heart so nicely. So I had this ribbon that I had made for the sewing album. You'll remember that I put some stretchy seam on there and made a frill out of it. And now I'm going to fold over the corner and cut it off. And I think this is a beautiful gift box to give. I put the fusible frill on the bottom here in the front so that I can tell them that that's the front of the gift. I think they'll catch on to that. I put this beautiful brooch on there, that crystal brooch, and now it'll open like that. You'll have the nice little doilies on the side. I also put paper doilies all on the inside sides of the box. Now I'm going to take the We Are Memory Keepers envelope maker, and I'm going to make those tiny little bows. I think we all know there's instructions actually on the 1, 2, 3 scoreboard is where I got the instructions, and then I moved over to that board to make the bows. And I love the way you just fold them and then fold the ribbon ends back on themselves, and you have yourself an easy peasy little bow. It's so cute. Then I take my Copic 100 marker, my black one, and go around all the edges. Now, believe it or not, there's black hearts in that paper. So And even my blouse looks like all the colors that I used on this gift box. Isn't that crazy? I was just looking at that while I do the edit. And so I took three of these black buttons and I put them in the center of the bows. I had to throw that in there. I just am so thankful to be on the design team this year. This is my second year and I enjoy Sherry's images so much. And now the last thing I want to do here is put some of this cheesecloth underneath our little image. I think this gives it a real pow factor when you put it on top of the box. It also gives it stability when the box is opening and closing, because when you fussy cut the image, of course I have the little strands of hair, I have the neck, the legs, and you know, you're bending it all the time, so the cheesecloth only made sense, especially for vintage shabby chic. It looks awesome. So I'm just adding some hot glue there, and I just love Sherry's images. And at the shop, I encourage you to go over and check it out. She has so many images this year. It's amazing. They're fantastic. And all of the paper line, and she has so much to offer there for mixed media. Go and check it out. You'll love it. And I really appreciate being on the design team again this year. I know I said it already, but I do. And I love coloring Sherry's images with any type of mediums. They're beautiful. So let's open it up. You've got the fuse tool on the outside with that brooch. You have the gold tissue, the doilies wrapped around on the inside. I really love that. I didn't show you that. It was doily hearts that went all the way around the inside and on the bottom. Yeah, so we're getting down to a close. Thank you for joining me. And please give this tri-coloring a try. You'll love it. You'll just love it. Sherry's images are gorgeous to color. And enjoy the pictures that I left at the end. And thank you very much once again for joining me, and join the other design team members for September. You'll love the projects they have in store for you. So take care, everybody. Have a blessed weekend.